bosses paid very closely. We talk, we chat on a weekly basis just to check what's happening within the projects here in the Western Cape and throughout the provinces. I'm responsible for the program called the People's Housing Process, whereby we as government capacitate communities to do it for themselves. I'd really like to send an apology, suspect the Homeless People's Federation, to apologize on behalf of the minister. She had confirmed Kuti Uzobanati today, but due to unforeseen stuff that would come up, as you would know, as a political principle, you know, they get called to different places to do stuff. Hence, she is not here. But Mxenge is here from her office directly. We're all within the department. And after the meeting here, after this whole event, Mxenge will be going back to the minister to report back as to how the event proceed today. I'd like to start by thanking E-Federation for inviting us, honestly. I am so passionate about PHP. You know, people always say to me, but PHP is not working, wala wala. I said, go to provinces like the Free State. Go to provinces like the Western Cape. Go to Mpumalanga. And Salma, we cannot thank you enough as a department, Mark, with all your support, your kids, the whole family, and the love to document this whole journey. Asifundeni bafowethu. Go to the library, or if you can, get yourself a copy of the book for you to learn ukuthi abafazi, what is it that we're capable of doing. And there's this saying yet, 880, watintu mfazi. That's what I wanted to say. And what is nice about this project was that it wasn't about a house, you know, as the ultimate problem. You actually build a community. You focus on HIV and AIDS. There's a crash, there's a food garden, there's this, there's that. So I think even with us as government, if we give our people the little that we can as government, and say to them, do it for yourself, they always go beyond what we had anticipated them to do. So all that I'm asking from you today is that, good people, read that book, go to CISPET, go to all the other ladies that were part of this project originally and say, how did you do it? Because we can still do it today. We say about Indian Zagalayo, Kulamalang, Kuti, people get, they call them government houses. You know, those that were built by developers and contractors. And then you come there after 3 months, it's no longer to me living in that house. It's Mr. Chikolo from somewhere else. You ask yourself, Mutikanja? Because it's that thing, you put in, these people were not, you know, they didn't like contribute towards the building of their own homes. But go to any house that is constructed through a people's housing process. Sometimes you'll find that the house doesn't even look the same. You know, people would have modified it. You know, about changing color, there's a veranda, there's a garage, there's this and that and that. So as an official who's responsible for this project, you'd all know that sesiqalile uMinister Sisulu, what she's saying now is that sizobhekana nabomama and the youth. So I'm gonna make a plea to the youth that is here today, nabomama abakhona ukuthi yazini, it's high time that rebofe. You know, we should tighten our belts. Abo baba, bak goka, is it to goka? They fold and their pants as well, because we're going to work. And abo fazi, abo mama, and the youth, you will be at the forefront. And we thank people like abo Sean, thank you very much for all the support, the assistance that you gave to this project. You know, you look at the units today, you look at what they're building on this day, and you look at what we used to have. They're totally different. It's because of those efforts of all the partners that were part of this program. And we really, really appreciate them. So let's go back, guys, to the drawing board against his pet. Mxenge will be also giving the minister the report, yeah, ama dynamics ally in the Western Cape. And what I normally plead with people would say, let's all come together, put our efforts together, and really work on this one. Thank you very much, Salma. Thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I really am looking forward to visiting here quite often with the team. and let's continue where we left off. Ngiyabonga. Thanks,
Reverend. I'd like to thank the Reverend Lande for his prayer, Councillor Pupa for his contribution, and to the program director for her management. I want to thank also all of you, the representatives of the SAHPF, who come from different regions, from Mpumalanga, Limpopo, Eastern Cape, KwaZulu-Natal, Gauteng. Is there anybody else I've left out? No. I'd like to thank the author, Salma Ismail, and her family for being here. The editor of the book, Glenda Young, she's right in that corner over there. I want to say to you that a university is a place of learning, and that's where Salma Ismail, who is the author, is working, and she did her research on this project. But research only stays in a university where, even if it's about people like you, you don't know what's being said. But one of the ways in which this research can come to people is through a book. And this is my role as a publisher, to tell the story and to spread it around the world, to send it so that other people can read it, and it reaches people like you, but it also reaches people who can change things for you. So what I'm saying is this book wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you. Thank you. And for those of you who want to buy the book, it'll be here for 199 Rand.